data science feeding the all-seeing beast. Pervasive data science is becoming a core enabler of business innovation and competition. Given this importance, it's worth examining the context of data science to consider its trajectory and future value. In my view, primary challenges around data science for business leaders comes from three sources. On episode 259 of the CXOTalk series of conversations with innovators, I invited two experts to examine these issues and talk about data science in financial services and insurance. The discussion included an outstanding exposition of the broader business context and value of data science, so we pulled it out as the short, standalone video embedded above. My two guests for this episode are, to learn more, check out the short video above, and read the edited transcript below. You can also watch the entire episode, and read the complete episode transcript over at the CXOTalk site. Merle Buliswar, the core challenge for the insurance sector is similar to some of the financial services. In insurance, you're trying to predict your cost of goods sold at the point of sale. Getting that right is absolutely critical in your ability to achieve margins down the road. Anything and everything that you can do to understand that at its core will give you a significant competitive advantage. Machine intelligence is the collective experience of an institution manifested through data. Now, if you zoom out from that problem statement, there are many similarities in insurance other industries around the role of data science and machine learning in augmenting human intelligence and making better decisions. More structured, granular, sophisticated, consistent decisions in sales and marketing, as well as in pricing, underwriting, and in claims, which is a significant part of the fulfillment of the promise that insurance carriers make to their customers. Michael E., what we call data science today is part of a long history of the application of mathematics and computing to industry. When I joined the industry, and I started my world in finance at Wall Street, back then we used to call these jobs quant roles. You would figure out how to trade in capital markets, make predictions about which way the stock price would move. I think what we've seen is that the tools and the technologies that we used there were then really adopted in Silicon Valley, really turbocharged, frankly made, actually, much more usable. Then the cost of computing made it so that you could apply this, not just to a few select problems on Wall Street, but all over Main Street, all over the rest of the financial services industry. Merle Buliswar, the first big dissimilarity, so to speak, when comparing insurance to other sectors is that the role of the actuarial profession dates back to the early days, when insurance was created as a sector. Analytics in insurance has largely been driven by the actuarial function, which brings nuanced competencies and capabilities that are relevant to insurance. If you think about the broader role that data science could play today in insurance, you can fundamentally reshape human judgment when it comes to sales, when it comes to underwriting judgment, even when it comes to claims through the lens of data and technology in ways that might not have been feasible 10, 12, 15 years ago. Like many other sectors, in insurance, you've got a sales or distribution channel. You've got a product channel that is around pricing the product. Some of that is your cost of goods sold, and some of that is trying to understand the market's appetite and the customer's demands, or demand elasticity if you will. Last, but not least, you've got the fulfillment of the promise of that very, very data rich. So, if you break down that value chain to its core elements, there are similarities to other sectors. Now the difference could be that, if you think about healthcare, for instance, healthcare is much more a transaction, data-rich industry perhaps compared to insurance. You're engaging with customers on a very consistent basis, just as you are in financial services, in banking, and credit cards and such. The difference, perhaps, between insurance and these other sectors is you're not necessarily as data-rich, as transaction data-rich, as other sectors. However, certainly getting your cost of goods sold right early on remains critical. Michael E., right, but you see this with retail. You see this through the smartphone, and we were doing a lot of that when I was at Foursquare trying to make that retail brick-and-mortar experience a bit more digital through your smartphone. You see this all over the place. I think that that's going to be a major driver of consumer electronics. You're going to see the need for companies to have data to drive interactions onto smartphones, tablets, and wearables. Merle Bulis were, to build on what you just said, my